Hello, once again, this is Torrin Atkinson, and it's Sunday morning here in Vancouver, BC, British Columbia, Canada. And you know what that means? That means it's time for a 20-minute monster. I'm going to turn down the volume on my computer. Let me know if that music volume is too loud, if it's overpowering my voice, my vocals. What happens on 20-minute monster? What is 20-minute monster, you might ask? Well, every week I draw a monster from one of the Advanced Dungeons & Dragons monster books. I did the entire monster manual earlier. No, I guess it was last year. Now I'm going through the Fiend Folio, and I'm on the letter F in the Fiend Folio. So I decided to draw the Flind? No. The Flump? No. The Flail Snail. That's right, you guessed it. It's time to draw the Flail Snail. So as always, please, won't you go to my website, torrinatkinson.com, artwork, find some wonderful original Dungeons & Dragons art. I put a bunch of them on sale right now for $55, I believe it is, marked down for a holiday, a little bit of Black Friday sale. And also check me out on YouTube. If you're not already on YouTube watching this, as I post my Twitch videos onto YouTube after they're done, some of them, not all of them, and Instagram and Patreon.com. Throw me a buck if you like what I do. Why not? Can you afford a dollar a month? If you can't, I'm sorry. Okay, so with all that out of the way, let's take a look. Where is it? Where is the... No, that's not it. No, that's not it. Did I delete the layer? No, there it is. Okay, great. Here is, from the Fiend Folio, Flail Snail. Now, it says number appearing 1. I'm going to draw 4. 4 Flail Snails, because that begins with F. And they are large size. You get the original drawing here by, I don't know who this artist is. You don't get any sense of scale. So we're gonna change that. This silicon-based mollusk averages 8 feet high at the crown of its shell and keeps its club tentacles, of which it has 4 to 6, in constant motion, flailing everything in its path. Amazing. In combat, each tentacle has its own hit points. Blah, 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 blah. After all the tentacles have been killed, the beast withdraws its head and the rest of the body into its shell. It will die in 1 to 3 turns, during which time it utters pitiful wailing cries, which have a 50% chance per turn of attracting a wandering monster. Now, in AD&D, a turn is 10 minutes, I think? The creature's body also has hit points. Oh, I don't care about that. Yeah, it does damage, yeah. The snail is immune to fire and poison, but it is hypersensitive to bright illumination and hence is always encountered at night or underground. Well, it's a good thing I didn't do... Well, I mean, the other thing I was thinking of doing was flail snails in a far-flung fjord. But I decided to do the foyer because I thought that would be funnier. The highly colored shell affords the flail snail partial protection against magic, acting as a type of robe of scintillating colors. Whenever it is attacked by magic, the effects are variable. 40% chance of the spell malfunctioning, 30% of it functioning normally, 20% of it failing to work at all, and a 10% chance of it being reflected onto the person casting it. So that's fun. So not only do you need a monster that can club you to death, but also messes up your magic. The shell weighs 250 pounds and retains its magical properties for 1 to 6 months after its occupant's death. So that's fun. It can be sold for as much as 5,000 gold. So that is the Flail Snail from the Monster Manual. I also found... I guess we can... just go... No, wrong tool. Just cut this in case I want to refer to it. Oh, I need to rasterize my layer. So sorry. So sorry for this delay. And delete that. I can put that over here, I guess. God, the tools. The tools. Jerry. No, Jerry, it's the police. All right, here's a miniature I found of the Flail Snail. This is 5th edition design. Still pretty good. pretty good. I like it. You can see the scintillating colors on the shell. What else we got? That's my fuchsia, because it's going to be a fuchsia. So that's going to be the color. Let me do a dark. We're going to have, you know, oh god, B. No. Oh, it's because it's, yeah, keep doing this. Rasterize that layer, you dumb. All right, we'll just keep this on hand. We'll try not to delete that. And then here's from second edition. I don't know who drew this, but it's 99, so you can see it's like right on the cusp of third edition. So, BKM. Who's BKM? Bradley K. McDevitt? Maybe. Huh. Anyway, that's pretty cool. I like the mouth. It's very yonic. Okay. And then here's my foyer that I grabbed. Originally, I was thinking like it would have stairs on both sides. I'm motioning with my hands, but you can't see. But I think one of Flail Snail is going to be covering one side of it anyway, so that's fine. So there's our foyer. I'm not gonna just draw over it. I'm gonna interpret it a little bit. So let's put it up in the corner for reference, and we will start drawing. Any questions? Anyone? Evil Critter says, "Sorry, I am late. I need to turn on notifications for Twitch again." Hey, no problem. It has been quiet in the past few weeks here in Torrent's Twitch channel, but I've also been drawing. If you check out I've been designing a T-shirt for the Darkest of the Hillside Thickets, my Cthulhu rock and roll band. This past couple weeks, and that's finally up on my online on the Thickets online store, Threadless. And yeah, that took a lot longer than I thought it was going to be, and it turned out a lot different than I thought it was going to be. But I'm happy with the design. There's some, when I look at it on Threadless, it looks like there's some weird artifacts that I don't see in my original art. So yeah, I hope it turns out good in the physical thing. I don't have a physical copy. I didn't order any. So I hope the people that order the shirts are happy with their shirts. Okay, so do we need anything else? This is my drawing layer. We're good. This is my... Should I put my two references on the same layer? Sure, why not? Let's just put that there. Merge those layers. Okay, I'm going to make it yellow so I can keep track of it. Do I need this one? I might need that one, and that's fine too. Okay, great. I also have... I voted on the T-shirt. I'll go check out the site. Thank you, Evil Critters. Snails actually have cute little cat mouths. Meow! Cat mouths? I also grabbed, I'm not gonna, well, I guess I can show you some pictures of snails for reference. Look at this, there's the volcano snail. It's pretty amazing. And there's a cute little guy. And yeah, look at all that. And that guy's pretty great. And that's back, that brings us back to the top, I think. Did we see this guy? Do we see that guy? I like the way he turns. He's turning around. He's got a very dynamic pose. Okay, great. So I'll keep those in a nearby at hand in case I want to refer to them, as I'm sure I will. And we can begin drawing. It is 10:09, so I want to be done at 10:29. I think I can remember that because it's almost 10:30. Let's do a rougherson. I will keep this handy. Where do I put it? I kind of feel like I want it over here, not on the... I can never select that tool. I'm still not selecting that tool. Oh, I am, but I'm on the wrong layer. Okay. Okay, so here we go. We are starting drawing now. Now! All right, so we do want the stairs going up. We want this thing. I'm gonna put a snail up here. Maybe one. Oh no! Let me think. Let's put one coming down the stairs, right? And they're big. They're not small. No. Honeycomb's big. Yes. Let's make the arch, make the entrance an arch instead of. Should there be more stairs going up? No. We'll just have another flail snail coming out of here. Should be coming this way? Oh, I know. I kind of want one to have knocked over something, so let's put a little pot here. I don't know, some flowers or something. Or no, a statue. Yes, a statue. And then, God, I gotta draw anatomy on a statue now. That was unwise. And broken arm, and he's looking. Oh, not with the, he's looking at the... Why I decided to draw four flail snails was probably unwise. I committed. This is the general shape. Flails. And then another one up here. God, they're like 8 feet tall. Why did I do it to myself? And then we'll cheat the last one. We'll just have a couple of flails coming in from the side. This is not a great composition, but let's see. We might just do what we do. Bam! Listening to some Johnny Quest. Okay, is there anything I need to... Maybe an eye? I guess I need to frame this if I'm gonna have... Well, at least on these sides. Bam! Everyone's looking at... Oh, I'm using the flails as if they were eyes, but they're not eyes, so... Maybe it's just one flail over here. Okay. Just get the proportions correct. If I can. I may not be able to. Coming down the stairs. Okay. Alright, so that is the... That's our... Make that layer. Get it out of the way. I'll need this for reference for stairs and shit. And let's draw the final. This is the color I want. I'm glad I kept that on hand. Let me check the chat. Will your elf be in peril again? I don't think elf's going to be in this one. Rudiger the elf. Let me get my snail references. Let's start with this guy. Should be fun. Dun, 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 dun. This is manic music to go with the manic amount of time I have. And they got the little, don't know what these are, little sensor organs. They're not. It's like, what did you do? What did you do? And each one of them, they have at least four. I'm probably going to stick with just four flails. If I like this design, maybe I'll tidy it up. And I had mentioned on one of my social medias that I was going to use his mouth under there. Let's not get caught up in the details yet, though, Torin. And this will be... Do you think they ever, like... Are the... Because they have curls on their shells. Do they ever... The curls ever go... Are they like always on the left or always on the right? That's something I never considered about the lowly snail. Okay. So that's one flail snail. That's fine. Come back to him. Do some things there. Okay. Let's do the top... Let's do Mr. Top Snail. Get rid of my reference for a second. Actually, no. Let's keep my reference because I'm going to draw the... wrong layer. I'm going to draw the... Maybe it's be like he's been flailing up there, so the railing is all busted and broken. Because it's a flail snail, you know? Let me get this guy's beady little eyes in before I... you. Someone's outside going through the recycling, making a lot of noise, those cans. Actually, just two, right next to each other. Sure, that's fine. And now the arch. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the arch. Okay. Why did I do this to myself? It's already 10:16. Okay. Oh, curves. Curves are hard. Oh my god. Painful. It hurts. Somebody help me. Okay. I need to make the eraser bigger so I can see it. Okay. Alright. God. What a nightmare. And, yeah, this is the... It's broken. You broke it. Oh, God. It's like the Venus. This is how the Venus de Milo lost her head. Looks like that looks like a whole bunch of nothing. I'll come back to that. I mean, I think I'll come back to that. That helps. That helps settle it a little bit. Let's get some perspective lines going here, and let's do these stairs. The stairs. Girl. Womp, 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 womp. That's wise. This is fucks up my perspective already. Ba 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 ba. Okay, there we go. It's fixed. Everything's nothing is fucked, dude. Nothing is fucked. It's interfering with my. I want to see what the hell's going on over here. That's fine. That's fine. Nobody cares. Up, up, up. Ugh. I keep using the tools, the shortcuts, as if they were... I guess this has to go here, right? It's the lower stair, the step, the steppiest. God, I just spend the entire 20 minutes drawing stairs. That's fine. You get the idea. And then this is, I don't know. Let's just do some. Let's not get too technical. Don't get technical with me, as C-3PO once said. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. And then just, I don't know, some lines. Okay. Let's do... Now let me get rid of this so I can do this guy up here. Which one? Which one should I do? Should I do the guy at the top of the stairs or the guy coming through the entranceway? Most snail shells curl to the right, apparently. The left curling garden snails are called snail kings, and their frequency is 1 in 40,000, according to Google. That's amazing. Amazing. Maybe I will put this guy... I'll put this guy more like front. Like, oops. Oops. Okay, I guess I'm doing him. I guess I'm doing that guy. Even though they're... They're not sensory organs. I'm kind of putting the... To emphasize where he's looking. I'm putting a couple of mimicking his... And I just put him there. I like it. What have I done? Oh, I made a mess, you bad snail. I'm gonna make my... this even lighter. Let's start to interfere with what I'm looking at. How are we doing for time? 10:20, 10 more minutes. Ding, ding, ding. Can't really tell that he's looking at this now. Let me see if I can fix that. With the power of illusion. Let's get, got too many lines, that's the problem. I need to look at my snail reference again. I'm losing it. I'm losing my... Where's the one that was turning? Yeah, that doesn't really help. That one, okay. Oh, God. Open the file I want you to open. Google, damn you. Damn you, snow! All right. So that's a shell over there. Something like that. Dun, 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 dun. That's gonna help me. Ba, 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 da. Well, actually, which do I do? What do I do? Bow, bow, bow. Okay, I need to hurry up. Four flail snails. Bow, 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 bow. So I guess this is one of those king snails. Bow, bow. Snails, surprisingly hard to draw. Okay. Let's get this guy over here. Maybe give me a one that's real. Yeah, okay. Bam, bam, bam. Bam, bam. I don't know, should this curve too? Let's have a curve for no good reason. Ba 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 da. The flails will be something like this. These flails are like as big as the ones in the mid-ground. Let's have him really coming right over the edge here. Everyone's directing their eyes towards the sad... This guy's gonna have five flails. So someone can't say, why did you only give all of them only four? They're supposed to have up to six. And I'll be like, fuck you, buddy. Something like that. Flails. Gotta put the bumps in the flails. Otherwise, they're just orbs. Let me look at the design again. That's second edition, but that's fine. He's got six. He's got five. Yeah, okay. What about this guy? Fifth edition one. This one also almost has like a membrane between the tentacles. I'm not going to do that. I think we're pretty close to being done here. Oh, we're going the wrong way. Da 1026. Okay, we're doing okay. I need to really draw this as if it was a thing. So let me zoom in. Do I need to look up the Nike of Samothrace? Do I care enough? Nike of Samothrace. Winged Victory. No, I don't want that one. I want the other one. I can't remember its name. Damn it. Famous statue. Venus de Milo? David? Or David? I guess we can use the Venus de Milo as a reference. Oh god, I'm having trouble selecting things. Venus de Milo. Anyone enjoy Milo? Okay. So. No, I'm not going to use the robe. God damn it. I'm having a lot of trouble right now. Okay. Head. Neck. No, the neck is going to be, the head is going to be separated from the neck. Neck, arm. Make it look like boobs. And then the head is like, oh my god, he did it. With a bun. It's always a bun. Look a little bit sad because she's broken. The head is huge. This is terrible. Doing a terrible job. I might have to shrink it as well. Okay. Dun 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 dun. Reminding me of my earlier drawing of the caryatid column. I don't know, it's just a statue. It's not any specific statue. Yeah, that's that's all right. That's not too bad. I kind of want to have her separated from her plinth. Is that what you call it? God damn you. Damn your eyes. So let's let me grab that. Let's make it a little bit smaller. And change the angle a bit. Something like that. That'll do. I broke it. Yeah, you did. You did break it. And then let's just put the head. I don't know. That's not exactly what I was envisioning in my mind. But, so now I want to change. I like this guy's eyes, but now they're not looking in the right spot. So I'm going to change it. Let me save my work before anything terrible happens. And, what else do I need to do? I can put a suggestion of a corner up here. Let's put another extra lip over here for emphasis. And then, oh my god, we're at time. We're at time, but I'm gonna make a slight adjustment to this guy's eyes. There are four. You can only clearly see. Is that what snail eyes look like? Oh, we're having fun. Why are we kids? Okay. What I need to do. Let's get that. Some more eye direction bullshit. All right. Let's get rid of this layer. And then I just want to put some... Since this is close to camera, I'll just fix this up a little bit. Because I'm in storyboarding, I use phrases like, it's close to camera. Which, there's no camera. There's no camera! I didn't draw any slime on any of these guys. But I guess that's the way it goes. Right? Does that work? Does this work for you guys? I don't want to put too much. Okay. I think this is our... this is basically our drawing. 32 minutes. Let me check the chat and close all my reference windows. God damn you. Damn you. Fantastic flail fun. Ford Fitch joined. Ford Fitch 42. Hey, hope you things are well. Things are not too bad. After this, I'm going to meet with my thicket co-conspirator, Thomas. And we're going to actually work on a song. We started a long time ago. But without too much more ado, the only thing I want to do is put a little texture on a couple of these guys. Proper snail texture to really sell it. So let's do that now. There's some lumps and bumps, you know? Because it's a snail. Some over here too. There's some railing here. Does that help? Just a bit of railing. Sure, whatever. Lumps and bumps. Lumps and bumps. Anything? Anything else we need to do? What's happening here? This is a kind of a mess, isn't it? Isn't it? Yeah, this one. Sloppy. Sloppy job on this guy. That's okay. And anything else? Do these guys get bumps too? Sure, why not? Put some Fregretto lines in there. And this guy, of course, he's our star, really. Not sure.
Drawing is hard, everybody. Drawing is hard.
Okay, this is it. Do I need to put any... I could try. Where's my other... Let's get this going on here. Let's do an underlayer just to see how it looks. It might not take. But let me move this here. And, alright, let's, I don't know, do we dare? Don't think it's going to help. Maybe it's best to do it for the background to make the flail snails really stand out. How about them apples? How do you like them apples? Is it going to work? That is the question. I know I said the flail snails are fuchsia, but actually everything but the flail snails is fuchsia. Let's just take a look and see if it works. And if it does, we'll keep it. How about them apples? I don't really think it works that well. I don't know. I don't like the way that brush looks. Maybe if I do it this way. Yes, that's a little better. Sure, I guess that's fine for a 20-minute drawing. Maybe it'll have to do. I don't know. What do you guys think? I kind of feel like... how can we highlight this area here? Does that work? Does that make it better or does that make it worse? It kind of makes it worse. Just use a little... a little bit here. All right. Yeah, that doesn't really help. Okay. Well, this has been... You know what I can do, though, that might help? I know, I keep almost ending. I keep almost finishing. Let's do... We can do this. We could do this, ladies and gentlemen. I know that kind of should be more black than... dark. Put this under that. And then this could be like... I would make these guys look a little more glistening as well. And then really just make this really white everywhere. I think that's the answer. I think that's the answer. I think that's the answer. I think we did it. I think we did it. Okay, so this has been... Now, for real, I got no room to write. Everything's so big. Okay, this has been... Let me get rid of this. That's nothing. This has been... New layer. 20-minute monsters. I really have no room to write. Flail. Snail. And then, as I always like to do, well, starting from, like, the last session, twitch.tv/ToranAtkinson. Thanks for coming, everyone, to the Flail Snail. Now I want to draw a snail. You should. That's Evil Critters. Ford Fitch says, dig the flail snails. I'm going to be painting one sometime soon. Really? That's great. The only thing, the other housekeeping thing we need to do is to look at our table of contents for next week. So we did the flail snail. Next week is the letter G. Can I zoom in here? And as you can see, there are many. And I put a little check. I put a little red thing beside Grimlock, because Grimlock is in the... There's Grimlocks in the Dungeons and Dragons cartoon. In... I can't remember the episode, but I can visualize the episode. I just can't remember what it's called. But I also really, really want to draw a Grell. So maybe that'll be the... It's an either-or. Or maybe it's a both question. Githyanki and Githzeri, also very popular. Garbug, don't know what that is. Goldbug, don't know what that is. Gorbel, don't know what that is. Galtrit. So many... and Giant Strider. Many options for next week. Join me again. Is there anything else left to say? Thanks for joining. Like and subscribe. Where's my off switch? Gorilla Bear does sound fun. So thanks, everyone. I got 5 viewers today. That's not too bad. And we're going to end at 40 minutes. I thank you once again. Please tune again next week for the letter G. This has been Toran Atkinson, 20-Minute Monsters. Bye-bye.